The federal opposition is calling on athletes to boycott having pictures with Labor MPs after Victoria pulled out of the Commonwealth Games. It's continuing its pressure on the Prime Minister to find a solution in a week where he's also been feeling the heat for a failing Yes campaign for the Voice referendum.
From the Prime Minister's public frustration...
Can I make a point, please?
..to a decline in the polls for support. It hasn't been the easiest week for the government and its plan for a voice to Parliament. But Labor appears to not want to dwell on it.
The referendum is a really important issue. I'm voting yes because I want to close the gap.
The campaign for the referendum is yet to begin in earnest because a date hasn't been set. And in the interim, the government is keen to point out there are other items on the agenda.
You know, it's not the only issue the government's dealing with.
One issue is unwelcome. The federal government has been drawn into the Victorian Premier's decision to ditch hosting the Commonwealth Games in 2026. And the opposition is continuing to apply pressure to Anthony Albanese.
He should take some responsibility. I'm not saying he should put the games on at Commonwealth cost at any, you know, any cost. I'm not saying that at all.
So
I'm
what saying exactly
explore,
should he do?
Explore creative solutions.
Those solutions are unclear, but the Coalition's former sports minister did offer some other unsolicited advice.
And I've got a suggestion, by the way, for all of the athletes. Don't have your photo taken with any Labor MPs until this gets sorted out.
The opposition claims until it's sorted out, Australia's international reputation is at stake. The Prime Minister is turning his attention to international matters this week, but for very different reasons. In a show of the Trans-Tasman partnership, Anthony Albanese is travelling to Wellington for an annual meeting with his New Zealand counterpart. Australia's relationship with the United States has also been on display as members of their navies marched through the streets of Canberra today. The parade was a ceremonial part to the joint military exercise Talisman Sabre that's continuing this week with forces from 13 countries. It'll be capped off with the US Secretary of State and Secretary of Defence making a visit down under. Ashley Raper for 10 News First.